Sonic Eva's Unbelievable Shaders PTGI E6 has been released on Patreon a couple of weeks ago, and to that occasion I'm going to show you how to install these path tracing shaders with Forge. You might be able to run all sorts of mods alongside the shader pack, but keep in mind that none of them are officially supported by the shader, and it is also recommended not to use too many mods, since the game needs to reload them all into memory every time you change the shader pack. I will therefore cover basic installation and a few mods to enhance the way Minecraft looks and sounds. This is a follow-up video to my first tutorial, but you don't need to watch it first if you want to install the shaders with Forge. I will cover everything in detail in this video. The steps I show in this video are the ones that I've taken to get it to work, but I'm not saying that they're the only way to do it. First, some requirements. It is recommended to have at least an Nvidia GTX 970 GPU. I am running these shaders with that, alongside an Intel i5 4460, and I'm getting around 30 FPS in controlled environments, and between 15 and 25 FPS during normal gameplay at 1080p. You will get better performance without Forge, and for that please refer to my previous video. An Nvidia GPU is required. The shader pack will not work if you have an AMD GPU or an Intel integrated GPU. I have also been made aware of issues with mobile, laptop-grade Nvidia GPUs. It might work, but it's not guaranteed, and you will probably get poor performance. As of now, Sonic Eva is still working hard on AMD support. As stated on the Patreon updates, Nvidia RTX GPUs have driver issues that cause visual artifacts and bugs. You might get more help in the official Sonic Eva Discord server. If you have error messages that appear in the in-game chats or experience any kind of visual bug, you can try to recompile these shaders by pressing F3 and R when in-game, or by installing all the drivers. To be able to use the shaders, you will have to support Sonic Eva directly on Patreon, at the gold tier, which is $10 a month. The shader pack will be released for free on Sonic Eva's website once development on it is done, but that might still take a couple of months, if not more. There is no official planned release date. The shader pack does not support 1.13 or 1.14. You'll need to run this in Minecraft 1.12.2 and in the Java edition. The Bedrock edition is not supported. First, let's cover everything that needs to be downloaded. All the links are in the description of the video. We'll be installing Forge, Optifine, the shader pack, a texture pack, an optional texture add-on that turns white glazed terracotta into mirrors, dynamic surroundings, better foliage, fancy block particles, sound physics, and all the required dependencies. You can download the zip file for the shaders directly from the latest Patreon post, labeled SEUS PTGI E6 release. To download the right version of Forge, visit the Minecraft Forge website, and click here to download the recommended version, which should be Forge 1.12.2, 14.25.5.2768. If you can't find it there, it should be in the Show All Versions menu. Make sure not to click on any ads, just click on the red Skip button. For Optifine, visit the download page of the Optifine website. I'm going to get the 1.12.2 HD U E3 version. I have heard that the HD U E4 Pre-4 from the preview versions gets better performance in some situations, so feel free to experiment with that. Make sure to click download, then click on the link to get the jar file. This should not be an .exe file. Now let's get all the other mods. Getting most of them should be pretty straightforward, just visit the links in the description and click on download latest file. If you get any issues, you might want to check the version numbers of the mods that I'm downloading in the video, and get the appropriate one from the recent files list. I'm downloading Uralib, which seems to be required for dynamic surroundings itself, Forgelin, a necessary dependency for better foliage, fancy block particles, and finally sound physics, which you download from the releases page on this GitHub page. They should all be jar files. We're going to start by installing Forge, but first you need to make sure you're running Minecraft 1.12.2. For that, get to the Minecraft Launch options, create a new option and select the 1.12.2 version. Make sure to start it up at least once. Then you can close out of the game and launch the Forge installer. Once Forge is installed, start Minecraft and you should see a new option appear. Select that one and click play. If you see this, that means that Forge has been successfully installed. Close the game again and double-click the Optifine jar file. This should open the installer. If it doesn't, try to open it with the Java Platform SE binary. Here, instead of clicking install, click on extract. This will create a new mod jar file. Now all the mods can be installed by pressing the Windows key and R, typing %appdata% and hitting enter. This should feel familiar if you've installed mods in the past. Navigate to the .minecraft folder and then to the mods folder. If it doesn't exist, create it and make sure it starts with a lowercase m. Drag all the jar files you downloaded into that folder, except for the first Optifine file. And add the Optifine mod file to them. Now we're going to install the texture pack. Go up a folder and open the resource packs folder. Open up the vanilla normals renewed zip file and drag the folder inside to the resource packs folder. You can then download the add-on in the description of the video, which should just be a zip file that you put directly into the resource packs folder. I'm going to rename this to remember what it is. Now, here's a last step that will change the game more than you might think. Create a new text document, open it and write HRTF equals true. Save it under the name alsoft.ini. Make sure you set the file type to all files and not to text file. Now drag this newly created ini file not into .minecraft but into roaming. Finally, make sure your default sound device is set to 44,100 Hz, which seems to be required for this to work properly. What this file does is making spatial sound a lot more realistic by basically enabling 3D sound. Now let's check if everything is installed correctly. Launch the game one last time, and in the mod options you should see that all your mods are loaded correctly. Navigate to options and video settings, then shaders, and click on shaders folder. Drag the PTGI zip file in there, and you should be able to select it in the options. These are the options that I'm using. I'm running the game at a render quality of 0.7 for better performance. Make sure all lighting is set to default and shadow quality is set to 1x. In the shader options, you have a couple of settings that you can adjust to your liking. In lighting and shadows, I'm keeping everything at default, but if you want brighter indoor environments, you might want to raise the block and torch light intensity. In the ray tracing options, full ray trace reflections is an option that will likely have a big performance impact, so turn it off if you're having frame rate issues. I still recommend keeping it on because the texture pack we'll be using looks a lot better when it's on than when it's off. Screen space reflection tracing will add nicely rendered entities like dropped items and other things that are close enough to reflective surfaces, but it will also cause visual glitches with highly reflective surfaces like the mirrors. Screen space GI tracing adds shadows cast by entities, and I don't see any good reason to keep it turned off, except for maybe mild performance improvements. You can also disable glowing redstone and lapis blocks here. You'll notice another option, diffuse GI trace length. I'm keeping it on low here, but you might want to set it to high to avoid light leaking into large indoor areas. There will be a good example of this later in the video. In the surface options, you can set the texture resolution, which is very important and needs to match the resolution of your textures. The texture pack I installed is at 16, so we'll keep it at that. I'm not going to change anything in the post-processing settings, but you can disable motion blur in here if you want. Once you're done with these settings, make sure the following settings are adjusted as following. In detail, make sure alternate blocks is off and trees is fast or fancy. In quality, natural textures should be off. If you're having error messages in the chat, but the game looks fine, you can just disable them in the options, in video settings and other, by turning ShowGL errors off. You'll notice that the Dynamic Surroundings mod adds a lot of really immersive sound effects, visuals, and it will also change the way your footsteps sound. It's also highly customizable. If you don't like something, you can just turn it off, such as the jumping sound or the cold breath effect. The aurora effects don't work properly with the shaders, so I recommend turning that off too. Finally, you will notice that the ray tracing works as intended, and the redstone and lapis blocks emit their nice, respectively colored light. If you want the reflective terracotta, you can enable that texture pack in the resource pack settings. And you'll notice that the block is nice and reflective. To finish this off, here's a look at the test world I created. where I tested all sorts of things with the new shaders. The save file is available in the description too, and I've added a large empty room at the end for you to make your own tests. You'll notice these bright areas in the corners of the last room. Those are because the diffuse GI trace length is set to low. If you don't want that to happen, keep it on high. The last thing that I will recommend is the R3D Craft texture pack. I find that it works wonderfully with the shaders and especially the wool with indirect light. I'll add links to it in the description too. Make sure you get the 1.10 bump map and PBR maps and not the shaders add-on. If you decide to install it, make sure to set texture resolution to 256 in the shader options. Note that the texture pack will reduce your performance. I still managed to get between 20 and 40 FPS in this map. I really hope you enjoy this new way of playing Minecraft. I could and have spent hours playing around with the dynamic lightings, and I hope you do the same. All of these mods are also compatible with 1.12.2 servers, so you can play online with your friends if you want. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe if you want to. I am not sure of what I will upload next. It will probably be completely unrelated to Minecraft or shaders or whatever. I guess you'll be surprised. Right, bye.